亲善面慈，护生命好。生命电视与您一同享受付出，珍爱生命。
接下来请收看大宝法王慈悲开示。
大家好，那大North America 长美的那个各种网络听古巴，那这样子纽约的大重开的，你那路里啊，这主要就是全部的，对，大家今天你们当不差的啊嘞，就是里头的啊，偏南边的大家那么跟女那么当。세계보몽삼세리아도마자시비숨주셔야잉
Today is the first day of our gathering here in New York City to celebrate the 9th North American Kajumanlam. So therefore I would like to begin by welcoming everyone who has come here, the lamas, male and female monastics, and male and female lay people as well.
Daka yu malam de thoma jeju kata nalo lea jaga lea wutsu jeju kata rumchi kukoma da nubuka rumchi shiwarshiwe nige antu ge da Zabala Dene Gotsu Burbutu Chungwe Bire Andi Jelaya Da Nyedong Tambelo Lea Nga Gyaalde Andi Ne Jumburu Mitoba Andi Ngarangi Nea Kajumalo Lea Jaro Tu Chungbure Kabji Dusane Tangbo Kajumalo Shilago Amada Kamsa Malam Rao Shilago Re Andi Ne Jumbe Shindu 그유몰람체제바명료교루대참도마세베기에네데지가루에명람근련샤티수이네야다지교활지지메베다가다지주추유송망보지추리체아니상계송망보다지가는야외기계베기송망보다루루체제예말랑군대제는유아를당아니말랑수아디니야좀니가서가래야예말랑수아를제대로중이브래
The celebration of the Kaju Malam in India was first begun by the previous Lord of Refuge Kala Rinpoche and the previous Bogo Rinpoche. And through their compassion and effort, the celebration began. And then in the year 2000, I reached India and soon thereafter began to convene it myself.At first, it was called the Kamtsang Manlam, but we changed the name to Kaju Manlam to make it more all-embracing and non-sectarian. We've also incorporated in the liturgy texts or liturgical texts that come from many different traditions, including the Buddha's words and Indian sources.
다다이대그유모람디토리미나오래안에통오래시나잡지계절없이다집유나근데기셔시오래이내다다람사지폐주요마네지상오래시나디린디순주나디림부치래야림부치나나야부도시가당의슈비인림부치나비이나오늘진해다고고라지순지루무치리아다지순지난갱기지칭이창어루지차디게비인주사네디균젠르데네는순지난비이나야부도스다이네루무치다리지폐무주비인자당해지마시라시라비도샤소
Now, in the case of our present Kaju Manlam here, it was initially my intention that His Eminence Jatso Prampashe come here, but he was unable to travel at this time. And I asked that he bestow the teachings because I think that he possesses all of the attributes of a fully authentic Dharma master.So therefore, I thought it would be best if he taught this. However, he's not here, so I have no choice.
That is the Sunju, that you must sing in the Sunju Chiajore, Tuni Vekul. The Sunju Jesse de Garazana, Jelamasonga Chimbi Zebe, and Lamjitro number Sundi, Lamzunum Sundi, but.
We have 3 days of teaching during the second session of each day, and the topic for the teaching will be the three principal aspects of the path composed by the great Dharma Lord Tsongkhapa. There are several commentaries on Tsongkhapa's three principles of the path. However, given the limited time at our disposal, I'm going to do my best to explain it based on the root text itself.
You have the root text?
I do.
Oh, yeah.对了几句那么多的恰子我说他的你给你蓝色的时候你叫我他们去看吧 공사 진호 친부초 군두 내차 가시 쉬브레 안 다는 신기 아주저디 남수디 당화주에 나눌래야 안 정글로를 타야기 슈수에 부두시 민주산에 안 디지 룽균으로 선한다 다 디지 토비아래 다 디지 인수샤인.
Now the basis for my explanation is that I have received this text, the three principal aspects of the path, several times from His Holiness the Dalai Lama, and also received the transmission instruction of it in the context of the Treasury of Instructions with the commentary composed by Zhongguang Guangchul Lodru Tai. So the text begins, I pay homage or I prostrate to the noble Lord Gurus. The essential meaning of all the supreme speech of the Buddha, that path that is praised by all holy bodhisattvas, the entrance or the way of entry for those who wish or seek liberation, I will explain as best as I can. This text can be divided into three parts, the introduction or beginning, the main body of it, and the conclusion. What I've just read through is the introduction or beginning of the text. The first line, I prostrate to the noble Lord Gurus. The term noble Lord, Jetsun, doesn't require explanation. Here, Tsongkhapa is prostrating to all gurus and especially to the Bodhisattva Manjushri. Now, why does he prostrate only to the gurus, but not to others? To indicate or remind us that the guru, the spiritual friend, is the root of all goodness.
Now,
the four-line stanza that follows this, there are a few different ways that it has been analyzed or explained. One way is to say that the first line, the essential meaning of all the supreme speech of the Buddha or Victor, is a preview or summary of the first of the three topics, the desire for freedom from samsara. And that correspondingly, the second line previews or summarizes the second topic, bodhicitta, and the third line, the ford or place of entry for the fortunate who seek liberation, refers to the third topic, the correct view of emptiness.
Yadi Karwe Tadadi Jaisun of Gunyimbutu Sunadi Energy Ninju Chansiata with all some Sungalia, the Kamba Kamba Ridis, the Sungal Jasar, the Dizzy Sungiabda. Tak Andra Kab Dilia Energy Karwe.
Now, of course, you could also see each of these three lines, first three lines in this stanza, as referring to the whole thing. So the essential meaning of the supreme speech, of all the supreme speech of the victor, could indeed refer to all three principal aspects of the path. But I think it's best to analyze this stanza as each of the first three lines referring or corresponding to one of the three principal aspects.
Dadi Jelia Anakanda Sibi Dadi Kizadi Kanda Sibi Della Machashi Tenju Tenu Chaji Trabi.
The next stanza says, whoever is not attached to the pleasure of existence and is diligent in making their freedom and resources have meaning, and therefore relies upon relies upon the path that is pleasing to the Buddhas, such fortunate ones listen with minds of faith. Then the next stanza says, without a completely pure desire for freedom from samsara, there is no way to pacify its suffering as long as one still seeks the fruit or result of a pleasure in the ocean of existence. Therefore, since it is by a craving for further existence that beings are utterly bound, therefore, first seek to develop a sincere desire for freedom from samsara.
That day, that Ginjung Sun Yuzan, that Ginjung Sun Adelia, that Tomajin, Ginjung Chugu Vigunzen, Ginjung Gibu Vigunzen, and that Chugu Vigunzen, and Dana Singi, Ginjung Gibu, a top Karimba, Dana Singi, Ginjung Gibu, Che Chidrimba, that Desum Yigone, that.
Now here, in this section concerned with the first of the three principles, the desire for freedom, Tsongkhapa presents three things. First, the reason why it is necessary in the beginning to develop the desire for freedom. Second, the means by which it is cultivated. And third, the measure of an authentic desire for freedom from samsara.
他这样就谈到的康萨，他把天津的康萨那么一，别你要是拿这个全网国外的那样，他第一拿的别急，宁波就不是那大多，别那个七岁的就开始了，但是严重那边他不是有了给我吃饿了。
What is being said here is that although there are indeed many aspects of Dharma to be practiced by an individual who seeks liberation, if one reduces them to their essence, first among all of them must come the cultivation of the desire for liberation. Furthermore, this needs to be more than simply the desire to become free from the three lower realms. It must be the desire to become free from all samsara.
That is the same thing that we have to do.都是在那一边的。俺这里就是那个，还是说的这，他妈，他俺从了这去这边搞的呀，还是老大。在这个缺竹路什么的，这个缺把这个竹路钱吧，怎么些个？缺竹这个月送上了，这个听不清，缺钱这个月送上了吧？等等，这个影响下些的啊，这个偏掉嘛。那做做的，俺得了就俺就有了呀。俺那的这个缺的特别缺了，主要了呀，缺你们的钱，这特别缺了，找了钱不了呀？哎，你们这，他说的这，他别有多少钱不了呀？眼珠子上吧，点不着光的是。
In stating the reason why we need to develop this desire for freedom, what is implied is that as Dharma practitioners, that is to say, those who have the wish to practice Dharma, the mere assumption.I am practicing the Dharma of the Mahayana is of itself a no help. For Dharma practice to work, for it to become a cause of liberation, we definitely need a stable desire for freedom from all samsara.
安德烈女士呢？答应那样子。这眼中下的给阿里亚的这刚说的这当给这看那些就算了，他不得不说了，但是呢我们这呢写他过呢这科幻的他就东亚人心里边通过去他来讨论对不对落这么没一个事呢他都写他过呢这是结果说呢他得来了不是吗这因为就算提就是这样的呢他过了还是这个，天亮俺就这个，就是壮大了些，老壮了些，关键的嘛，他是这个说这个，人心给的这个，给他眼中了些，给他下去没明白，因为就算地球在那点呢，是他这个，这个东岸送给他们下山了，壮大，大了你东岸个那是，这个就上完了。
However, while it is easy to talk about the need for desire for freedom from samsara, and even to talk about the means through which it can be generated, it is much more difficult to give rise to it. Because in order to give rise to the perception that all of samsara is suffering, and in order to lose or transcend all craving for the temporary pleasures of samsara, we need to engage in training. This is not simply going to arise spontaneously. It requires education and study, such as study of the three types of suffering and so forth.
That did in the business, cancer, I was talking about. Daniel, business, I was talking about. What다 한다얌 지기 가족 아주 지기 남기 라바숨기냐는 세외가래야 다 고림신도 배 냠스 내용도 산에 당부 지기 수림계 라바 냠스 내용 거야 지 순교하래 다 지기 수림계 라바스 대야 안 다지 대냠래 세외가래 임비냐 다 지기 예벌 중에 오늘 전에 지기 수수 지기 타바 되는 인게 지 강사 지비나 안 타바 되니 로고로 봐. 지금 수수 미유디 타베 공바 토야지 리지 인구로 봐. 드니 주산에 에너지 진짜 많이 비치지. 수수 그 미유디 안 다지 천디 기베 지금 대화 텐도냐로. 안 다지 세노롱지 텐도냐로. 안 이제 녀라 텐도냐로. 진짜 차위미나. 안 그 타바 되니 처어 말해. 그 미유디 타베 공바 토야 되고 처어 말해. 내면 이주산에 아직 수수 출림 송아 타바타비 줄은 로만로 뒤쪽에 타바 퇴행이 르 지금 지심은 스스로 왜 근데 지금 샤고야 샤디가 와서
We begin the cultivation of the three trainings taught by the Buddha with the first, the practice of moral discipline. And authentic moral discipline really requires the motivation of engaging in it in order to achieve liberation. If not, if one's motivation in one's pursuit or practice of moral discipline is to become happy in this life or to become wealthy or famous, this, because it lacks the motivation of seeking liberation, this is not a cause. Of the achievement of liberation.
That delia, them gi, chigay, that dung of shiayare, that dung sananda, that pitching of the bit of shiayare. They got a son of that lamazilia, lamazig, conditioners, conditioner, that goody guinamin shadi, that goody guinamin shayara, and the 年少中举，啊，就年少中举，年少中举，举举，那你吃个当，你这年轻人吃，对的，提不清不缺来的，提不清不缺来的，拉嘛了，跟着学来的，对，拉嘛对的，对是年轻人，南京去，吃的，他讲年轻人在去，这看难度关的什么当个去。 家里有个印章，俺那公给得了两块钱不是呢？他提不清不是个缺的两块钱呢？提不清不缺意思？俺提不清不是个缺的两块钱呢？提不清不缺意思？俺让你了，提不清不缺也没，提不清不缺也没意思。这里姐姐，来，哎，哪个的意思？
I'll tell you a story, something of an example or instance of this. A disciple once asked his lama, the practice of sarvavid, the practice of varochana, based on the tantra for the purification of lower states, a yoga tantra, the practice of sarvavid, is it a Mahayana practice or a Hinayana practice? And the Lama was evidently a strong practitioner because instead of answering on the spot, he looked inward. And then he said, I think if it's practiced by a true Mahayanist, it is Mahayana Dharma. If practiced by a true Hinayanist, it is Hinayana Dharma. But you and me, the way we practice it, it's not neither.
난 다른 신기 더 주버가 유기 다더 주버가 유세 이 아주다 그 유나는 여대버디 쇠딩에는지 장바결에 차리와래 다 공기 숨은 날에 대 잡어도 되어야래 그래서 나다 지 딩사 미디 상으로 최게 통보를 가보도 되게 최게 배 타니 배 통보도 좀 봐 주시지 지기 첨부 첨부사로 지 자기 첨부 지 언제 좌바 첨부사 우마 첨부사로 내게다 지 직 토부도 좀 해주셔야지 안에 지 다와 통동도 공바 삽동도 지금들 망고도 이나야 다디 최디 좌바 첨부 입에 편견면도 강사디 좌바 첨부를 놓고 안도 아 다디 내손 내 손을 잡아 내 망고 아래 세마도 다 내 놓고도 마도 안에 최다 강사님 그 버릇이야 되네 배 가서 gap 소머로 다지 파동으로 이제 배 미저 망보 샤샤나 데 저거 민두스 다 미저도 숨고 말어 다 데 잡으지 된다 알아 데 데 숨어 알아
The great founder of the Drukpa Khaju, one of the 12 branches of the Drukpa Khaju, Lord Tsongpa Jari, said, nowadays, people like highfalutin jargon. Everything's got to be maha this or maha that, maha mudra or maha samdhi, the great perfection, and so on. They want all these high terms. But it doesn't help if the Dharma is the great perfection, but the person is not greatly perfect. In that way, we sometimes leave a gap between where we are and where the Dharma is. And a lot can fall through that gap.
제가 나들로 구주 첨부요. 구주 첨부. 아, 삼다는 지기. 다다지 아주 지기 최대 티베 첨비 지기. 내가 다지 상하게 초가로 지기. 냠네 제 땅 알아 지 상하 상하게 초가 지기 냠네 체대기 상하 냠네 체대기 송아도 전대요. 이나 제 다지 지규리 상하 냠네 지기 메디 수수셈을 쭉 하고 이제 수술직 상한 양수 내하게 배 차기엔도 뭐 손에 차기엔서는 나도 하나 간다를 직 뒤 배 다 갖추어다 직 근원으로 그지 노담인도 안 다른 생 아주 직 자주 선배기 다 간다 배나 배나 다 갖추어다 직 배 티브 신비기 측 그 준주 측으로든지 망고 껴니 엄 된대요 알아. 이제 뉴스 안에 다지 소소에 지금 티브 신비 측이 아무리 지금의 소소로 된대요 알아디냐 소소기 오늘 전에 지금 생기 시부라 근롱 간제지도 아 심지어 탐지라 지 인지다 신편게 삼바 치중 거지도 다들 따고도 와. 다고도 마도 인샤샤 젠주스 다지 티고신비 쳇 줍데버 롬 아나싱 상아 쳇 줍데버 롬 바데기 핑미도 다 오늘 전에 다 간다 레도 미도 다제 쳇네 슈다당 제주 쳇고
There's a lot to learn from these statements and these stories. For example, We practice Vajrayana rituals, and therefore we think we're practicing Vajrayana. But maybe we need to question that. Are we really practicing the Vajrayana? Are we prepared to practice it? Is our motivation the motivation required by the Vajrayana? Similarly, in the case of the Bodhisattva teachings, we may have learned a lot about the Mahayana. We may know a lot of the terms, we may even have memorized and be able to recite the Bodhicharavatara. And because we do this, we think that we're practicing the Mahayana. But what is our motivation? How much compassion, how much affection do we really have for beings? We have to look into this. We cannot simply assume that we are Mahayana practitioners. We have to investigate our motivation. One way that this is put is that the only difference between the desire for freedom from samsara and compassion is that one is inwardly focused on oneself and the other is outwardly focused on all other beings, which means that in a sense they are fundamentally the same thing. The desire for freedom from samsara is a compassion for oneself, and compassion for others is the desire to free all others from samsara. This means that if the desire for freedom and compassion are the same thing, then without the sincere and stable desire for liberation from samsara, it would seem very, very difficult to have authentic compassion. If someone doesn't care for themselves, how can they care for others? Similarly, without the desire for liberation, there won't be authentic compassion. And without compassion, there cannot be bodhicitta. So all of this has to be based on a stable foundation. I must be getting old because I'm finding this text very, very difficult to read. So in preparation for tomorrow, I'm going to print out a copy of the text with really, really big letters so I can read you more of the root text.
So because
most people took the vows of renewal and purification this morning, It's important that the meal that the lunch be before noon. So I'm going to stop teaching and we'll conclude with the dedication prayers for the living and for the deceased that are customarily recited in this session.
Yeah.
佛教慈悲置业基金会以宣扬佛陀正法、培育优秀僧才、积极社会公益为旨志。20多年来，借由各项法务推广宣扬佛法慈悲智慧，如全省各中心的成立，让信众有学习佛法的道场，实践了弘扬佛法教育的功能性。尤其印证佛经法宝结缘，让大众接触佛法，明白因果业报观念，才能断恶修善，改善命运。所有的方便法门都是为了引导现代人认识佛教，学习佛法，才能离苦得乐。这是慈悲置业的长期以来的使命。为了护持佛法永续，利益更多众生，佛教慈悲置业基金会邀您继续护持，共同推动慈悲置业的各项会务，让佛法甘露遍洒各地，润泽群生。护持邮局划拨账号50444468，50444468，户名财团法人佛教慈悲置业基金会。
佛教慈悲置业基金会总管理处，地址宜兰县三星乡三星路2段20号，电话03989-9319，03989-9319，传真03989-8787，03989-8787。慈悲置业云林观音讲堂举办八关斋戒礼拜药师宝忏暨护生，恭请慧泰和尚、广护法师共同主法。日期12月17日星期六，时间早上9点开始，地点云林观音讲堂，云林县湖尾镇新南里竹围60-3号李斯特加油站后面。洽询电话05-633-1565，05-633-1565。敬请与会菩萨做好防护措施，并保持社交距离。当日上午8点半，斗南火车站前备有接驳车。
大家好，我是盛竹如。接种 COVID-19 疫苗可以降低感染后的重症与死亡风险。为了保护自己和身边的亲友，我已经接种第4剂疫苗了。除此之外，维持防疫好习惯也很重要，戴口罩，勤洗手。如果有疑似症状，可以先做快筛。也请多关心年长有慢性病或重大疾病的亲朋好友。疫情变化多，请您与我一起完整接种疫苗，备妥防疫物资，落实防疫护安康。
上堂课当中，我们讨论了第一个问题，什么是暇满。然而就算了解了暇满，知道了我们具备了条件和所在的处境，可是不知道它的利用价值，也没有太大意义。所以接下来 我们就来讲讲侠满人参的作用和优势是什么。按照佛经里面的说法，并不是每一种生命形式都适合修行。比如在佛教宇宙观当中，四大部洲里面只有东南西三个部洲的人有能力修持佛法，而在天人当中呢，只有那些曾经在过去世精进修行，留下了非常深厚的佛法熏陶的玉天，才有可能去修行。除此之外，所有其他色天、无色天等各类众生，以现有的身心和状态，是无法升起道心的。古印度月观论师所写的《弟子书》中说，如来道所依，能引导众生，是有人身德，心力广大故，道非天非龙，亦非非天德，非金翅驰名，非复行似人。意思就是说，因为人心力量巨大，所以我们人类的身体对于那些行持如来道，以六波罗蜜引导众生的菩萨们来说，是最好的选择。而既不是天人，也不是龙族，不是阿修罗，或者任何其他种类的众生。这些说法可能从道理上啊，大家都能理解。但是呢，一旦放在现实生活中，无论是四大部洲还是非人天人，感觉上都有点遥远，很难立刻产生共鸣。所以我们就试着站在现代社会的角度想一想，人生的价值是什么，究竟能带给我们什么利益。首先呢，我们来观察一下自己的处境。可能很多人对身边的环境已经都太熟悉，甚至感到麻木了。所以要换个角度，从一种更大的视野来看看，我们到底生活在一种什么样的境遇之下呢？从我们所处的社会角度来讲，大多数人都生活在和平年代，既没有战争、饥荒，也没有天灾人祸，没有极度的痛苦和煎熬，算是过得安稳舒适。那么再从温饱的角度来讲，可以说是不愁吃穿。纵然日常生活中呢，也会有很多压力、责任或者身不由己。虽然快乐的时光不少，但也谈不上啊事事顺心。所以总的来说，算是喜乐参半。然而，就是这种时而痛苦、时而快乐的人生，带给我们一个巨大的优势。什么优势呢？它能，我们有时间又有动力去思考，然后去反问自己，我们人生的意义和目标是什么。实际上，这就是佛法修行的动力和源泉。所以说，假如每天的生活都是痛不欲生的话，是不可能有任何精力和机遇去思维观察的。反过来也是如此，如果每天的生活太舒适、安逸，像在童话故事里面一样， 那也不会产生想要从中抽离出来的念头。谁想从美梦中惊醒呢？所以呢，从六道的角度来说，投生在三恶道或者天界，都是不可能去好好修行的。正是这种苦乐参半的人生，才是学习佛法最好的沃土。有苦有乐，有忙有闲，有思考的能力，也有可以去做自己想做的事情的机会，刚刚好适合修行。所以呢，我们说生而为人是六道之中最好的修行状态。不仅人生的状态给了我们很大的机会去修行，而且我们的之父人身也是最好的工具和载体。比如说，因为我们有了这样的身体，就可以去布施、顶礼、帮助其他众生。而我们的语言能力，让我们可以去持咒、念经、广传佛法等等。所有这一切善业，都是要我们身体力行，才能去积累和完成的。而相比之下呢，这些无形的众生们就很难做到。不仅如此，我们的感官功能让我们可以去聆听法教，或是去实践一些禅修的方法。我们的想象力和创造力让我们能够去进行各种观想和观修，而大脑的思维模式和记忆力让我们可以去思辨参悟佛法的内容，让我们不仅可以充分理解，而且能将真意融入自心。所以呢，无论从哪一个角度去观察，都不难发现人身的能力和作用是很多其他众生都完全不具备的，所以说是望尘。